Hello friends, today we'll be learning various sketch relation in SOLIDWORKS and how to use it in SOLIDWORKS. So let's see. Now let's see the various sketch relation in SOLIDWORKS. So basically these are the various sketch relation in SOLIDWORKS. First is horizontal, second is vertical, third is co-radial, fourth collinear, fifth is perpendicular, sixth parallel, seventh concentric, eighth midpoint, 9th coincident, 10th is symmetric, 11th equal length, 12th pierce and 13th fix. So let's see in SOLIDWORKS how to use it and where to apply it. So let's go in SOLIDWORKS, create a new tab and click OK. Now I will basically create some sketch and show you how to use the relations. So I'll be selecting various sketch options like circle lines. Now first we'll see horizontal. So basically I want to make this line horizontal, so just click on that line. Here existing relation will be shown and add relation option will be shown. So here basically I have to make this line horizontal, so I will click on the horizontal. It will make the line horizontal. Now suppose I want to make this line vertical, just click on that line. Now select the add relation and click on vertical, so it will make the line vertical. Now suppose I want to make two lines collinear, so select the line, press Ctrl and select the other line. See, here basically all the relation related to the lines will be shown. So now we'll first select the collinear. See, this line will be 1/1, so like this collinear will be used. Now again select the first line, select the second line using the control option. Now we'll see how the coincident option work. So just click on the coincident option. See, it will get coincide. Basically I have to just extend this line, so I will just select the extend entities and extend this line. See, basically this line will be coincide to this line on this point. Now we'll see the other option. I will just create other lines. Suppose I want to make these two lines perpendicular or parallel. So just go in add relation, select the line, select the second line. Now it is showing me the option of perpendicular. So just click on perpendicular, both this line will be perpendicular. If we just extend the points, we'll see both these lines are perpendicular according to the relations. Now we'll see how to use the parallel. So I'll just create two lines and make them parallel. Just go in the add relations, select the first line, select the second line and select the add relation option, that is parallel. So it will make both the lines parallel. Now we'll see the relation equal. So suppose I want to make these two lines equal in length. I'll just delete this first. Go in the add relations, select the first line, select the second line and select the option equal. So it will make both the lines dimensionally equals. Now we'll see relation related to circles. So first press Ctrl, select the first circle and then select the second circle. This is basically shortcut for adding the relation or using the control option. Now see, all the option related to circles are shown here in the add relations option. First is co-radial, means it will correlate the circle. See, both the circle are one on above, so like this co-radial relation will be used. Now we'll see the other relations. Just select the first circle using the control option and select the second circle. Now second option is tangent. So both this circle will be tangential at point. Now this relation can be added between a line and circle also. Suppose I want to make this circle tangential to this line. Just go in the add relation, select the circle and select this line and select the relation tangent. It will make tangential. Now we'll see the other option related to circle. Just go in the add relation, select the circle, select the second circle. Now we'll add the relation concentric. So basically in concentric both the circle will be having a same center. Now we'll be seeing other relations. Suppose I want to make this circle fix at its point, so I will just select the circle and add the relation fix. So we can't move this circle anymore further, it will get fixed at that particular point. Now we'll see the relation symmetric. For that we have to create a center line and check whether the line is properly vertical. Now the line is properly vertical. Now we'll draw two circles. First is on the left hand side and second I will draw on the right hand side. Now basically symmetric relation will be same as like of mirror. Suppose I want to basically mirror both these circles, so for that I will be using the relation of symmetric. So just go in the add relation, select the first circle, select the symmetric line, it will be our mirror line also, and select the third circle. See, here you can see the add relation option, that is symmetric. Just click OK. So it will basically make the both the dimensions equal and the distance between them equal, as in like if mirror. Now we'll see how to use the pierce option. So I will just delete all this sketch. We'll just draw a circle, exit the sketch. Now select other plane, suppose that is perpendicular to the front plane, so I will select the right plane and click on the sketch, make it normal too. Now I will just draw a spline. Now basically I want to use the pierce option. For that go in the add relation, select the point and select the circle. See, here you can see the option pierce. So basically this pierce option will be more useful while using the swept and the loft command. So like this we can add the pierce option. Thank you friends for watching this video.